Okay, so this video is going to be about addressing the comments and me reacting, and I want to like clear the air about some things. So everybody has a big problem with the age gap, but I really don't care if you have a problem. That's your problem. He's a grown adult. He's over 21. He can make his own decisions. I'm an adult. I'll make my own decisions. If I want to see someone younger, that's me. Don't worry about it. You can have opinions. That's fine. But when you insult me, I'm going to have a problem. And I'm going to come at you. And obviously, he doesn't have a problem. Or he, you know, if he had a problem, he wouldn't even have came to see me. And, you know, he wants to come back. And I just don't get all the hate. I don't get it. Like, what is the big deal? When older men are with 20-year-olds, no one bats an eye. It's you know, like, oh, he's good. He pulled this young, beautiful woman at his age, you know. Woohoo, let's root him on.
It's because of their money.
So I just...
Too. I was kidding.
And I'm broke. And he knows that. He knows.
So how she pull him and she broke? Yeah, Hayden.
Trust me.
California, that's crazy.
I'm saying.
He knows I'm broke. So it's just, it's crazy how much of a problem you guys have with that. Because it's not your relationship. And I do get some people saying, you know, they're worried that he's going to like cheat. And I can't predict the future. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what he's going to do. I know what we've been through. And I'm not going to say what we've been through. I don't have a problem with his age. He doesn't have a problem with mine. We go on live and we've addressed this so many times. We don't care about the age. Now, I'm also getting hate over texting Julio. Okay? Oh, God. Okay, was it right? Absolutely not. I should not have been doing that. It is a form of cheating. It was mentally cheating, but it is still cheating. And I reached out to him when I was going through so much stuff with Luis. He was there for me. And I've already said this before, and I don't want to keep getting into that. But yeah. It was wrong, and I never should have done that.
At least I don't follow her on TikTok. Ellie's life.
Aww.
Trying to bring attention.
And I also chose to share that with you guys, and I didn't have to. But I was not prepared for the amount of hate. And I do mean hate. That I got from people who I thought were my true followers. Like, you guys turned so quickly, it was disgusting.
We're gonna start calling you guys airheads.
Yeah, because really.
Y'all be sour, then y'all wanna be sweet.
Yep.
Hey, hey, hey. Don't steal my slogan.
That's a sour patch.
Sour patch kid, first of all.
I was about to say, airheads are good.
I thought, oh yeah, airheads is a sour patch kid. You're right.
Yes.
But yeah, I chose to share that with y'all because I do share a lot of my life with you. And I didn't have to tell you nothing about it. That could have been just between me and him and me not even tell you. But I do regret telling you guys that I was texting him because you turned on me for no damn reason. Saying, you were just saying so much and you don't know what's happened.
People be acting like they're holier than thou, to be right honest.
Act like
they're
so perfect.
They've never done anything wrong in their relationship,
yeah.
In their
yes.
life.
And it's crazy how they're like, they switch up. They
yeah.
really do.
So quick. So quick you switch up. So I think I'm going to like have my guard up from now on and maybe not like share too much with you guys anymore because of your nasty, disgusting comments.
Privileges revoked.
Like, seriously, like, I'm just done oversharing with you guys. And I always wanted to share everything. But now that you've done what you've done, I just don't think I'll ever do that again.
And it's like, it can never make you guys happy. First, you guys are like, we want to know where you met, what happened this. But then you guys are like, you guys are oversharing. Don't say that.
What do you want?
Trouble.
What do you want?
Yeah.
Like,
it's crazy. Like, I don't get it. Like, go back and look at all the hate comments. I want you guys to go back on that video and look at all the disgusting things that were said.
Go back on the video from Haley Nadix 2.
This girl. Oh, man. Lisa and myself were the ones getting hate.
I know. Me and Patty was getting all the hate.
Yup. Go see in the first video what Patty did to piss y'all off and read the comments.
But a mí me vale. Because only my real friends know.
Yeah.
The type of person I am, so.
Yeah. Unfortunately, we just stuck with her at this point.
That's crazy.
She's too dirty. You know she's like.
I'm just kidding, bitch.
Yeah. Y'all see her?
Yeah,
you
put me through.
Patty's like, when this camera turned off, it's on, girl. Turn you off your own balcony, damn it.
And also, you don't get to see what goes on behind closed doors, like after we're not filming. Like, you don't know, like, what we go through. You only get to see, like, portions of our lives. So to make assumptions and to like hate on us for certain things, it's so wrong. We have feelings too. And your words affect us greatly. So watch what you say. It doesn't take much to be freaking kind. Like watch what the hell you say. And I feel like there's so many miserable people. Like, to be honest, when you're happy, you don't think about hating on someone because you're too busy being happy in your life and everything. And when you're like a miserable person, you want to like make other people miserable too. You want to bring them down. And it just shows me how many miserable people watch my channel. It's like, Jesus, get a life. If you're gonna be that miserable and hate on me, unsubscribe, leave, go. Because when you go, 10 more will come. I don't give a shit.
Breach.
Yes.
Mic drop.
Amen.
Boom.
And a lot of people assume that he's doing it for clout. I just don't see it. You know, he made the choice. He has options. He can be with someone his own age or choose to be with me. That's his decision. I didn't go running after him. Remember, he was in my inbox. So it's his decision who he wants to be with. So I don't think anybody should be talking crap about that. And I have options. I chose him also. So I just don't get it. I don't know. What are y'all's opinions?
I feel like every relationship is not always going to be butterflies and roses. Obviously, y'all are going to have your ups and downs. But I feel like y'all communicated with each other. Y'all know. Whatever happened, you know, y'all look past it, y'all want to move forward. So I feel like that's a good starting point, especially if you're trying to really be in a relationship.
Yeah. We have talked about the Julio situation, and he's forgiven me. I've forgiven him for the things he's done. And if he's able to move on from it, why can't y'all? I don't get it. Why can't y'all move on from it? We're okay with it now. We've talked about it, and he's moved on. But you guys keep hating. I don't know. I'm just so tired of it. You know, I just want to be happy with someone. And if he's making me happy, what's the problem?
I don't think there's any problem with it. But there's just keep in mind, there's always going to be people that they want to see the negativity. They want to see the drama. That's most of the time that they're looking at your content for. And the moment they see that you're happy and they're not, that's when they'll strike. So it's part of the industry that you're in. So just start looking past the negative and just look at the positive.
It's crazy how like once you like present like you show someone on, like, for example, you show Louise, they're picking sides. Like, why are you guys picking sides? Mm-hmm. Like, they're together, so you just if I'm like, you guys are over here agreeing with him or agreeing with her, like, why y'all picking sides?
Also, it's almost like I kind of regret putting him on camera, because now there's females that don't like me that are in his inbox just to mess with him because their dislike for me. So there's this female who went to his Instagram and told him, hey, this is me shooting my shot. So he sends me the screenshot of who she is in the message. So I call her FaceTime. And of course, you know, she didn't want to answer, blah, blah, blah. You was only doing it just to get at me. You have to be so goddamn miserable to do that. Like, you take the time to do that. I don't get that either. It's like, you're trying to mess with someone's man just because you don't like the woman.
If you have the ex to send him, have the ex to face her.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, and then there's other people, other females that go on our TikTok lives and will say, oh, you're so cute. Forget about her. You don't need her. But where did you come from? You came from my channel, right? So why go to his and tell him all that dumb shit? I don't get it. I know we have been arguing lately about him addressing these thirsty hoes. And him wanting to know who said that, because the comments scroll up and he's wanting to know who that is. Like, you don't need to know. You don't need to tell people your location. Why do you need to do all this? What are y'all's opinion on that?
Explain it again.
Okay, so
I feel like you should tell the guys from their point of view, and then we'll,
Tell the guys.
Yeah, okay,
tell the guys.
So there's females on our TikTok live that will go to him and say, "Hey, you're cute," and but the comment goes by, and he sees he's cute, but he wants to know what girl said it, and he wants to acknowledge them and say, thank you.
I feel like I'm trying to think of words to say before I get in trouble.
He said, I'm hella close to my wine. She's right in front of me.
Not Ellie turning her.
Taking a compliment but not acting upon it will be the better route, I believe.
Yeah.
It'll be the right thing, because I feel like it's also, in a way, disrespecting. Like, for example, my wife, if something like that was to happen, it would be disrespectful to her, and I'm pretty sure for her it would be embarrassing, because, you know, in our case, we're married, and if I was to entertain something like that, yeah, it wouldn't look good.
So. ¿Y tú?
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Yeah,
I think you should really ignore it, and, you know, just kept going.
Yeah, you're like, open it, but not act upon it, and not really care who said it. Like,
yes.
I said, in this industry, I feel like they're gonna be people to test, push your buttons to see if you're really in it to be in it, or
yeah. I keep telling him all the time, people's gonna test you, and you're failing at this shit. Like, you're failing miserably. Don't react to them, because they're testing you, or people want to prove a point. And you're failing. Don't fall for it. I've told you a million times, don't fall for it.
Exactly. What about the, like how she said about the location? If a girl asks you,
where do you live? Yeah. Like, what city? Like, to ask where you live.
All right, bro, when you wake up dead on the floor because somebody broke into your fucking house.
It's a California thing.
I'm like, damn, bro.
Yeah.
California. Likes the pot. And I'm kidding.
Yeah. But yeah, we got an argument over that. I don't know. You just don't need to say crap. You know he's from California. That's all you need to know. And for you to disrespect me and go on there and say, oh, he's cute. Like, so he is supposed to come back. He's already booked the flight for August 15th. He's going to be here. We got some stuff planned to do. I was like, so shocked that he came. I didn't think he was going to come, and you know, I'm so happy that he's already booked the next flight, and he's already talking about like maybe October he would like to come here and look for a job, maybe buy a new car, and you know, try to settle down. So we'll see where that goes. All I know is right now we're just living in the moment. We're happy. Can't predict the future. We don't know what's going to happen yet. But right now I'm just living in the moment. I'm not thinking too far ahead, because I'm too scared to do that. Because every time I've tried to do that and think something's going to work out, it doesn't. It fails. So I don't want to think too far ahead. I just want to live in the moment and be happy. You haven't heard Haley drink water. You haven't heard Haley drink water.
Haven't I woken you up?
Mm. Well, this is my only food. Him up.
The loudest culprit.
Oh. He no, he like.
He's like,
really?
Yeah.
Okay,
it was
okay. Okay.
It was pretty
loud.
I'm just there, you know, just drinking my water, cleaning,
you
fucking.
Too?
You're like, damn.
Oh.
Patricia.
Oh.
What?
I thought you heard Haley too. I was like, damn, how hard are you drinking?
No.
Be like, Liam.
Oh.
I'm cracking me up.
Long Beach, California.
Boo.
Y'all, back on YouTube.
Back on YouTube.
Well, I haven't posted in a while.
Look out for the merch. October 19, 2024.
Patty the Bad.
Patty the Bad. Okay, so another thing I want to address. Oh, people keep saying I need therapy.
I don't know.
We
I
all
don't
do.
Want to do secondhand that.
We all do.
You think I need therapy, bitch?
You have us. That's all
right?
Therapy you need.
This is my therapy.
You're fucking crazy, too.
Seriously. Like, I don't need therapy. I can't change what has happened to me. And I don't think anybody can change the way that I feel. And the way that I'm always going to be paranoid, because it keeps happening over and over. And I didn't bring past traumas into the new relationship. Trust and believe, I did not. There's issues that was there, you know, while we were together. So, but I don't need therapy. And I'll always have my guard up because of the shit that has happened to me. That's never going to change. But no therapy, someone's, you know, sitting in a chair is not going to tell me, oh, you don't need to, like, be worried about your future boyfriends or husbands or whatever. Yeah, I will be. I'll always be worried because I never thought my ex-husband would do what he did. You know, you're not prepared for that. That mentally destroys you. You know, I thought we were going to be together forever. Yeah, he had cheated a couple of times.
But it's not more like necessary, like, it's not gonna take it away. It's more like a process, a healing process. Mm-hmm. Like, I guess they give you, like, exercise to, like, how to heal or, like, you know, or how to, like, handle it more. Like,
yeah.
Handling it, like, more. Because, uh-huh. Like, that's why I said, like, everybody, I feel like everybody needs therapy because I feel like everybody has been through it. Something. You know, not necessarily always has to be like your past toxic relationship. Like, it could be like a family or like yourself.
Yeah.
You know, but I mean, because for me, like, I actually want therapy. I just can't afford it.
Uh-huh.
But, you know?
But it would probably work for you because you want it and, you know, you think you could benefit mm-hmm. from it. I'm not going to benefit from it. I don't think anyone's gonna like convince me not to stress over it, because more likely it's gonna happen again. I just have to like prepare myself or like get out of the situation and not keep dealing with it. But I don't think therapy doesn't always help. Let's put it like that. Therapy doesn't always help people. It helps quite a few people, maybe most, but I just don't think it's going to help me. But yeah, that's, you know, another thing that bothers me is people keep saying over and over, you know, get help.
Yeah. How much is therapy?
It's expensive. It's probably like $100 an hour.
$100 to $200
an hour.
Does
he sit there
and listen to people?
Yeah.
I'm a great listener.
You guys call, my phone number is, call me.
No.
Cash out.
No. You're going to try to get me in trouble, bro.
No, I mean, like, you know, charge an hour. Like, bro, what's your problem?
Oh, I'm be like, hold on, boss, hold on. What's up, bro? Make it quick. I'm turning wrenches.
If you got to make an appointment, you got to go with Ellie.
Oh, yeah.
What was y'all's impression of Luis?
Well, I only say hi to him. Didn't really interact.
Yeah.
But I mean, I have a couple friends and family members in California. I think they're really dope. I mean, he didn't really rub me off the wrong way.
Wait, what do you think?
Yeah, I feel like he did seem like a...
What do you think about your future stepdad?
Yeah.
You know, he wasn't nothing crazy.
No.
He was shy.
He was shy, but he was down to do stuff, which I kind of like, you know.
Yeah, he decided to do stuff.
I can understand someone being shy, but then also being like, let's go do things. I kind of like, I dig that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
First impressions, yeah, he seems like a good
dude. Like a cool dude, yeah.
Yeah, he definitely wanted to do stuff.
You guys might care about more my opinion.
No, Patty, you probably should
stick. They already,
no, you go ahead.
No, but honestly, it was pretty cool. We actually were all hanging out. We went to an arcade, and it was just Luis, and myself playing game boards tonight.
Oh yeah, we were.
We were just and we're laughing and talking.
Yeah,
it was a good time.
Yeah, I had fun, and they got along.
Don't be judging for what y'all see,
right? Because like, what you don't see. No, we had a good time. They got along. They were laughing.
Yeah.
So, you know.
He kept having good luck on winning us, and it was his first time.
Yes. Yes. But yeah, him and Patty's in a good place right now.
Don't worry, I already apologized.
Yes, she apologized to him, and they're good. So don't be coming at Patty.
Yeah.
Don't be coming at her no more. Like, I'm done with that.
And I don't mean to address it to you guys. Like, what I said or how I said it, because I said it to him.
Yes.
And I even said it on live. So if you missed it, it was too bad. So sad.
Yes. You can follow us on TikTok.
So, yeah.
So do you consider yourself a cougar?
No! A cougar is someone that goes after younger guys. I don't go after them.
It could be someone who's attracted to younger guys.
Isn't it someone that dates younger guys?
There you go.
I thought it was a cougar is like a cat that like goes and hunts them. I don't hunt these bitches.
He's
like, they're in my inbox.
What's a cougar?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Like,
you asking
Siri,
bro? Really?
It's an animal.
Yep.
That's what it came out.
Look up what's a female cougar.
It's an animal.
It's a female animal.
One of the most dangerous species in the world.
It's gonna have these on it.
I'm gonna go over there and touch it.
Stupid. It's gonna have my face.
Get away from me, it's angry.
Told you, actively pursues it. I don't pursue this shit. I'm not going after these.
But are y'all?
She's like, they come to me.
Exactly. Like, I'm not, like, seriously, like, out looking for it. I'm really not.
Oh my god, too. And I always wanted an older man, but it's only dumb guys that hit me
up. You look cougar too, Patty.
Why you want an older man? You gotta take some blue chew.
I'm not old. Blue chew. Like, in his 30s, at least. But it's always young guys. I recently got hit up by a 21-year-old. I'm like, oh. No.
Why do you like brown?
Are you what?
Why do I like brown? Brown mint?
Like Mexican, bro.
Oh! I don't know. It's the brown skin, the dark black hair, and the big brown eyes.
Yeah.
It's just so. It's so attractive.
So attractive.
Oh my god. It's just yummy. I'm sorry, but it's yummy.
She loves it when they talk Spanish.
Yeah. Yes. I'm just, there's just, I don't know. I've always been that way. My very first crush, I think when I was like 10 or 11 years old. No, it goes back even further. I think I was in second grade. So how old would I be? Like maybe like 8. So when I was 8, the first boy that I liked had black hair and big brown eyes.
Oh, damn.
And then when I got older, my celebrity crush was Ralph Macchio from The Karate Kid. From The Karate Kid. And I don't know, ever since then, I've been attracted to the dark-haired, tall, dark, and handsome. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. It's just...
Did you not tell?
So yummy.
Lisa's literally Mexican.
What about with the other girls? What do y'all prefer?
I have no time.
I like
her. I really don't have type.
She's like,
good answer.
Right? Not to say that I wouldn't ever date outside of that, because...
But you like what you like.
I like what I like. Damn it.
Yeah, because it's like, yeah, you know, let's not sit here and lie. She's not.
I would like what you like. I recently, it was funny because my boyfriend, he's seen like old pictures of like guys I used to talk to, and then most of them had beard, and that is something that I am really, really attracted to, beard.
Uh-huh.
And he told me one time when we were fighting, we were arguing, and he's like, go back to the guy then, the one with the beard, since I'm the one that doesn't have one, huh? And I said, like, that's why you want me to grow it out. I'm like, no.
Damn.
That's not why I want you to grow it out.
Can he grow it out, though?
He has, he's gonna have, like, a little, like, stubble. Like,
Alex. Yeah. It's a goatee, Ellie. Let me go ahead and clarify. Beaches? Them beaches that were saying that my man should shave, go mind your business, go shave your butt. Like, what the hell? For real! Stupid. Not enough for mine.
I think your goatee.
Oh, yeah. I like the goatee. That shit's sexy, the fuck.
I like a little bit of facial hair. Not like.
Yeah.
Too much, I do like facial hair.
Yeah.
I don't know. I find that attractive.
Man, I'm in my third year trying to grow this damn beard. I finally convinced her, y'all. I'm over here trying.
Lisa, now it's all about her boyfriend that she has one and forgot about being spending time with the others that stays upstairs with her boyfriend talking. What? Even on days Patty and Ellie goes over.
Bitch, my man is from California. Of course I'm going to spend all the time I can with him. Hello? I can be with these people any day.
Yeah.
Like, don't be dumb.
I don't see you every day, bro.
Okay, so Lisa now is all about her boyfriend that she has one and forgot about being and spending time with the others. Now that she stays upstairs with her boyfriend talking even on days when Patty and Ellie goes over. So yeah, of course I'm gonna spend time with him. He's from another state. I don't get to see him. I can go around the corner and see these people, my friends. You know what I'm saying?
Damn, my house. These people. Huh?
When are you gonna come to my house then?
I'm scared of the dog. I'm scared of the dog.
Excuse me.
I can lock the dog up.
Denver? Okay. You're scared of Denver?
Yeah, he's a pit bull, right?
He is the biggest
pit
bull. No, he's a great guard dog.
No, I'm scared. I seriously am.
You have blue eyes. Bro.
He's still got teeth.
If you kiss him, I promise you, he'll turn him into Prince.
Oh. I'm scared. That's a big ass dog, too.
He's not that big.
I will steal that away from him.
I'm still bigger than him.
So cute. I love dogs.
So what's he a mix of?
Catalina leopard.
Yeah,
and
he's supposed to be Catalina leopard dog, but he don't look like it.
There's still pit in there.
He's
still
a leopard
pit.
Some breed.
But yeah, of course I'm gonna spend time with him.
If it wasn't for Alicia,
he's like just editing.
Talking to it and being close to Patty, Patty would hardly be there.
Is it if it, what?
Damn.
Wait, what was it? If it wasn't for Alicia talking to and being close to Patty, Patty would hardly be there. That's a motherfucking lie. I at least text these bitches once a month, like, hey, we're doing, we're gonna, you know, do a little hangout at my house, like, you know.
She's the main one drinking.
Yeah.
She's the party started.
Yeah.
Doesn't hang well, yo, get your DJ Bert. We'll go get a couple drinks after.
So what did it say?
He likes nice girls.
Haley never lets her man hang out with his friends and have boy time.
I feel like it's just like,
he doesn't need to. I'm his only friend.
Not the only friend.
Yes. I have a lot of personalities. You just got to tell me which one you want. And it's all.
No. There's only one bird. There's only one bird.
I say don't let him go.
What?
No.
I want to go.
No.
Why?
Nah.
We can go to Barnes.
Yeah, why can't we go? Why can't all of us go?
We see her 24/7. I let her come by herself. You don't see me with her 24/7. She's like, I'm gonna go hang out with my girls. I'm like, you go have fun, babe. Let me hit up Alex. Alex, sneak out the house, bro.
No.
Please, bro. We go over here some longer or something. You just play with your games. Like, oh, she's been caught. Just
go. I have a question since you brought that up.
All right.
Okay, so me and Luis FaceTime at night. We watch each other sleep. Like, we sleep next to each other on
weirdo.
FaceTime.
Yeah, you're a weirdo.
I don't care, you can say whatever. anywho.
Not that bad sleep, girl.
I do. I watch him sleep. I watch him sleep.
You don't need to see you sleep.
What the hell is the character? Have you seen a man go?
I don't know. It's my man. I love him and I want to see everything.
Oh, but when I say it, it's a fucking issue, right? What the hell? I'm telling you, it's always different. The shoe never fits.
So, if you was FaceTiming her sleeping and you wasn't living together, Ellie, would you get offended if he told you, hey, babe, I want a break. I don't want you to sleep with me tonight. Mm. How would you feel?
If you're already
even though you've already been doing it.
A and little bit, yeah.
You get hurt? Butt
hurt? Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I've done it before.
Would you be, like, do you want a break from that sometimes?
Yeah. Only because, not, because sometimes I feel like if we do our same routine and stuff like that. I feel like for the relationship not to get boring, she will need time for just her.
Okay.
So that's why I allow her, if you want to go hang out with your friends, go hang out with your friends.
Uh-huh.
I'm just so confident in our relationship and the fact that I know that she's not going to do anything.
Okay.
That assures me.
Okay.
But I don't want to be to the point, it's like what I explained to Ellie. Her and Liam are my comfort place.
Right.
But the minute that you, I'm not really a patient person.
Uh-huh.
But the minute you're like assuming or, you know, telling me, oh, you're doing this, you're doing that.
Uh-huh.
Knowing that I just go to work and straight home, and then there's days that I want to hang out with my friends, and you want to be controlling, that takes away my comfort place. And I'm going to go seek it somewhere else. Not necessarily with another girl, but I'm going to sneak out and go hang out with the homies, or not wanting to come home right away, right after work. I'm probably just going to chill in the parking lot, wait a couple minutes, be on my phone, and then go home.
So basically, let that man sleep. He don't need to see you sleep. He
okay, so
sleep.
Everything you just said is pretty much what he's told me. Okay, but I do have trust issues with him, so.
But I feel
there's
like
a
that's.
Difference, I but, feel like.
But I feel like the difference between I feel like with me and Ellie, we have that communication.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
She lets me know even if I'm at work and she calls me, she's like, "Hey, I'm gonna go hang out with Haley today after work."
Uh-huh.
Is that cool? Like, we have that communication with each other, so I feel like that's where boosts our trust with each other. Because I do the same thing with her. Like, if I'm getting off of work, like, I'll be like, yo, I'm hanging out with my boy Miles. We're going to go to Barnes. We're going to do this.
Uh-huh.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
So I feel like that's what helps is the communication.
So that's key, communication.
Damn, I'm in a relationship like Ellen and Bert.
Right?
So
right?
Homework for today, Lisa, is don't FaceTime him when he's asleep.
No.
If he wants his space, he can have it. Oh, I'll give it to him.
You sound crazy.
I feel
give it to him.
I feel like what y'all need to work on is that communication. It's just building trust. I know, like,
it's hard to build trust after.
I get it. Me and Ellie's relationship wasn't always the best. I mean, during high school, we were on and off. And not necessarily because we didn't want to be with each other. It's just we had different interests in that time. We were still trying to figure out. And, I mean, if it was meant to be, it meant to be. Obviously, it meant to be because we were together now.
Yeah.
But we did. There was a time period when we met you guys. We broke off. And we needed time for ourselves to figure it out. And I feel like that's what helped our relationship because in the beginning, Ellie was a little bit, like, upset. Like, even if we went to the freaking mall and the girl was like, oh, you have a good day. And I was like, oh, thank you. You too.
She flip you out. Get stabbed. You
not no more. Ain't no fucking good day for you no more.
But something happened recently, and he defended me.
Oh.
And yeah. So what happened?
So we went to Townsend Mall. I was looking for clothes because me and Ellie decided to start going back to church. And so she was looking for something for her to go to church. Well, she went to the dressing room at Forever 21. There was this girl that walked to me when she went to the dressing room and asked for my number. While I'm holding my son.
So,
I want to sit there and tell y'all that they go after married men, y'all call me crazy.
That's so gross.
Like,
and you really think my man gonna go out?
But like I told, I feel like what I told Ellie before, I can control what I do. I can't control what other people do.
Yeah.
So don't get upset with the other people. I know where I'm in a happy place with you. I don't want to lose what I have. So I end up telling the girl, I know you saw me with my wife. You obviously see my kid. Don't disrespect my wife. And she walked away, and the employee that was there was like, did that really happen? I was like, right, that shit is crazy, right?
Damn. But,
I feel like, I mean,
thirsty.
If you really, I feel like if you really care about somebody, you're not gonna do bad decisions. Yes, there's temptations at times. But if you just, but if you take a second and just think about what you got, I feel like you'll make the right decision.
What you gonna lose? Think about it before you act.
Like I feel like there's no female in the world that can give me what Ellie gave me. She gave me a home. She gave me motivation. Aww. If it wasn't for her, right now I'm pursuing my dream to be a mechanic. I'm not necessarily in the field of repair cars. I want to do customizations, high performance, and stuff like that, but I'm in the field right now, learning, and she's supporting me every step of the way.
That's so cute.
That's adorable.
You guys have relationship goals.
Right?
But it took us a minute, because I'm telling you, it's ups and downs. I know I did a couple things that she didn't like, but she communicated that with me, so
I did
was try to be better, and that was it.
I see that with Weddle too, how me and him were so on and off also, and now we're like actually communicating. Like back then I'd be like, oh, I'm going with my friends. He'd be like, why you spend more time with them than me, But now he's like, oh, okay, like, have fun. Like, I don't know, I think it just takes time.
Yeah. So do you think I'm overreacting when I get upset when he says, no, I need a break tonight, not tonight?
No, he's gonna throw me a fart in his sleep, damn.
I don't know.
And then he's gonna release him when he has sleep.
He does that
there.
With me. He does that with me here.
Yeah, I think you're overreacting.
Do you really?
No, the hell.
I don't.
Thank you!
You're welcome.
Thank you!
I feel like y'all shouldn't be too controlling. I mean, it's okay to be jealous, but to a certain extent, it gets kind of overwhelming.
Overbearing,
too.
Okay.
But also overwhelming, because it's like, even if I just do this or do that, because there was one time, I'm going to say the story. We went to eat out at a Chinese buffet somewhere in Douglas. She found a picture of herself with no makeup. And then she was like, who the fuck is this? I feel like at that point, you're like,
did you really do that?
Yes. And I'm sitting there about to take a bite of my lo mein noodles. And I'm like, you?
That's you. And don't make a mom beat.
And then she's like,
recognize yourself.
Like, I don't know. I feel like.
I can't.
I like her.
Who's this bitch?
I don't know her.
Yeah,
I'm kind of want to see. I would hate to see that.
Oh, no, that's hilarious.
I don't
oh my
think
God.
I've seen Ellie really like mad.
Oh my God.
Man.
She's
like, oh. She's gonna get mad. No, Lisa, me, honestly, I feel like don't be afraid of the relationship. Like I said, whatever goes around comes around. And don't take it as you losing him. You're just losing the problem. That's it. Your life is still gonna continue. You're a grown woman. I mean, you got two beautiful kids. You did right. You raised them. So.
You did that on your own.
Yeah, for real. Yeah, regardless of, I don't know your story, I don't know what exactly happened, but you're here today. And you're still living your life. That didn't stop you.
Yeah.
So
that's
don't think something bad is going to happen. Because that can fuck up a lot of
that's
shit.
Up,
I know.
Yeah, that's up to him if he messes up or not, you know?
That's true. I do overthink things, and he says he's tired of that. He wants me to, like, give him a break, that he can't, we can't be together 24/7. But me, I don't see the problem. Like, why can't we sleep on FaceTime every night? What is the problem? Like, what do you need to do? Like, what's gonna happen?
So you guys were doing this every night?
Yes.
Like, so I guess it's just because you're used to it.
I am used to it.
All of a sudden now you want a break
all
of all this time that we've been used to it. Why?
Right?
I get it. I mean,
sometimes a phone overheats, man, and then you're
charging.
That's
what he told me. That's what he
and
told me.
The
he
fucking
was like,
phone breaks, and then you have to spend another a fucking phone today or $1,000. That's crazy.
A hard phone can explode too.
Yeah.
To be very honest, I have. I'm not even kidding.
Phones could be.
He told me
$200. It's just the phone you want. It's $1,000.
Well, the phone I want is $1,000, y'all.
That's what he told me. He said my phone overheats. I need my alarm. I can't keep it charging. And if I don't keep it charged, it's going to cut off and my alarm won't go off. But it hurt my freaking feelings. And I feel some type of way about it today.
I feel like you shouldn't take it like personal.
I mean,
I feel like, be honest with yourself too. I mean, if it was here in Georgia, I'm pretty sure you'll want some time for yourself too. And not necessarily just to mess around, but like time to do you, you know, do
right.
Get yourself taken care of.
Yes.
You always have to make sure that number one is good.
Exactly.
For you to take care of the other people. So.
Okay, I get it. Mm-hmm. Okay. So maybe I am being too much, but I don't think so.
But honestly, I don't think you're a bad person.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's whatever you went through in your past.
It's true.
It can affect some people, but I feel like if you just, not everybody's out here to attack you.
Okay.
So you gotta start somewhere, you know?
Right. Okay.
And if he does mess up, like I said, life continues. Like.
But yeah, I'll give him some space.
She's
like,
5 minutes.
She makes me nervous. Fucking Louise is gonna call. You did this. I'll be like, what did I do? I just gave myself a 5 minute. You want some space? That's it.
Let me ask you, my thank you, because you're gonna be like, you made her understand a little.
All right, man.
Still
remember
feeling something.
Make it work. Don't fuck it up.
Right?
Because then she's gonna be like, "Brr, you're not allowed to come over tomorrow." Fucking Louise, no, I'm just kidding.